Hi, I'm Elia from Ubiquitous. Welcome back to my channel. Previously, we have been playing with the PID controller with the virtual drone on the website. If you haven't checked it out yet, I strongly suggest you do because it's going to be a great way to get a feel for what we are diving into today, and it is completely free. So I put the link down in the description and also refer to my previous video as well because it's a series. Today, I'm going to talk about what's PID control in the slide, and then we'll talk about why we need it and how it works. And then finally, I'll go over the Python tutorial so you can have a same setup so you can control this environment in your Python script, VS Code, and then you can also plot the graphs as this simulation goes on. So if you are ready, let's just get started. So what is PID control? PID stands for proportional, integral, and derivative. It's a kind of control system that is super important in engineering for getting things like robots and autonomous cars and the width exactly where they need to be. For instance, imagine you have this autonomous car, and then if you need this car to end up with this red traffic light, and this is the exact situation where this PID control comes in. The PID controllers are awesome because they are pretty straightforward and you can fine-tune them by trial and error. They are really effective for keeping dynamic systems under control, which is why they are a favorite in robotics and automation. Now, how does it work? So we're going to break it down into proportional, integral, derivative. The first part is proportional, and this is a basic but crucial. Say your car is a bit off from your target location, you're pressing the gas pedal proportionally based on your distance, like your error, like target location and my current location. So that is my error. And then I'm pushing the gas pedal based on this distance. And then the output, which is the gas pedal or RPM of your car, is like this, error times a constant. Kp is a constant representing a sensitivity. Sometimes you can put into unit conversion factors and so on, but empirically saying these can be adjusted by trial and error because it's literally a sensitivity. However, the caveat of this proportional control is that if this is the only thing that we are looking for, the problem is this car will reach to a target location. However, what's the velocity of this car? It's because we've never stepped on the brake pedal. So this car will just pass this traffic light, and then when this error becomes the opposite direction, and then this car will come back to all the way back to where it was. And then we'll just keep doing this forever. Now, another example of this proportional control is our half drone simulation. So at this very moment, this drone has this angle, -33.5, and our set point is 0. So our error is -33.5 minus set point, which is 0. Then this error is multiplied by this KP or proportional gain, which is 0.1. And then after multiplying 0.1, it's going to be -3.35, and in the integer value, it's just going to be -3 or +/-3. And based on the throttle, this +/-3 is added or subtracted to left and right motors. For example, on the left-hand side, we obviously at this moment need to decrease the motor output down. So based on the throttle, we subtracted 3, and then we added 3 to the right side motor so that the right side can come up. And then this is just not 11 there. That's because there's an integer convention and then float values are just truncated. And by the way, if you wonder what's throttle, throttle is just base output of the drone because the drone need to maintain its altitude. So it can't be just 0. But again, it has the same issue. When this drone is at the 0 angle, the angular velocity will be very high and there's no brake system. So we need a brake system. So how do we actually implement the brake system? And that's the derivative term. So again, our error is defined like this, and then that's a desired angle or angular position or something, and then minus your current state. It could be angle or angular position or position itself. Now, if I take the derivative of the error, the desired value or desired angle is just a constant. If I take the derivative of a constant, it just goes to 0. And then minus current angle or a current position and take the derivative of it, it will be just velocity. This derivative term is just looking at the velocity of your system, and then if the velocity is too high, it will just lower down the velocity. For example, here's this proportional controller, and then as I increase this derivative term based on this velocity, it will just blindly try to lower down the angular velocity of the system. It's called the PID controller. From the previous video, we have seen that when one of the arm length is biased like this, and then this PID controller cannot control this because their assumptions are like a balanced system. And if we integrate this error through time, like just literally summing up within the while loop, and then integrated error will be saturated at a certain threshold. In this case, it's 100. The PID controller is doing its best, but the error is still there. It's called the steady state error. And then when this steady state error is integrated, it could be a very good cue so that we can compensate this much to bump up the motor on the left side or right side if it's the other way. That's the PID control together. So at the end, your acceleration or your output of your system can be the summation of the proportional derivative integral terms together. And sometimes I think it's a little boring because it's just all plain equations. So I have prepared a block diagram, and then we have defined error, which is target minus current state. And then this error is being calculated on this circle block. The reference signal is same as target, and then position is the current signal. And then this position and velocity, the current signal is coming from the state observer. This can be just sensor. And then from the sensor, it can measure the position, velocity, and other states of your vehicle. And then it will be feedback to your controller. And then where is this sensor coming from? It's coming from the actual dynamics of the system. And what is the dynamics? In this exact case, in the simulation, the game engine's rigid body dynamics is the dynamics I'm talking about. And in real life, it's the universe is the dynamics I'm talking about. Now, finally, this equation can be represented into P, D, and I, respectively. This part and this part are divided into these three different rectangles, and they are summed by this circle. And then output, which is acceleration, is feed to your actuator to control the system, and then entire loop starts again. Okay, now I'm in the VS Code. I have downloaded all this template code from the GitHub. I put the link in the description section. You can always refer to it. Also, if you wonder where to get this, all these code instructions step by step, I have uploaded all this code in my website. Just go to ubicoders.com/courses, and then there's a free course for a very simple PID. And then just get in there and then go to classroom, it's free, and then you'll have exact same environment as I do. Now, let's go back to the environment setup, and then I just cloned it, and then I have also installed the Python environment to run this. And then this is the default VS Code setup. We're going to connect this simulation environment with the Python environment in the VS Code. And then the server is prepared in this vr_server.py. So I'm just going to run this Python vr_server.py, and then the server will be running, and I'll just click the connect button, and then it's just connected, and then I'll just ignore this annoying warning, and then I'll just turn on the new terminal. Here I'm going to run this default vr-half-drone.py template script, which is Python vr half drone tap.py. Now if I run this, we'll be just connected to this simulation, and this matplotlib plotting graphing tool window will come up like this. And if I try to do nudge to CW, and it will just in real time graph its angular position of the drone right now. And then if I just turn on this, and we'll just try to control it like this, and then since it's a proportional control, it will be oscillating all the time, and it's dying out. That's because the signal here is crazy, because the output of this PWM is coming from the built-in controller, and then also I'm setting the PWM like this, which is just constant value, so we need to implement our own in Python. So for now, let's turn off this And then now this PWM is constant here, which is just 1, 2, 3, 4. And then it's just 0, it does nothing. Yeah, if I try to nudge CW or CCW, it just doesn't really control because literally there's no controller implemented here. So we will implement this. For now, let me stop it. Now let's go over the code first. So half drone is just defining this Python object for this. And then this ubiquitous main is very similar to one in Arduino code, setup and loop. Setup will be called once only at the beginning, and then loop will be called every time when this Python receives the data from this simulation. And then literally, I'm just defining the value TS is states.timestamp, which is coming from this simulation. And then theta here is angle. And then theta dot is the angular velocity. And then I just put minus there. If you wonder why there's a minus, look up my slide section. And then the throttle is defined from here, like base throttle. And then just plotter is just updating the current timestamp and the current theta in this loop. And then it will just stack up about 100 data points. As if I go into definition of the real time, max entries are 100. So if you want to increase it to 500, you can just say max entries are like 500. Then it will plot 500 data points in the previous history. And then you are setting up this PWM of the half drone on the left and right. And then just rest of them are just zero because there are only two motors. Now let's define the proportional controller. And then set point is zero. I have defined it as zero. And then my error is set point minus current angle theta. And then I just define KP as 0.5. And then I define left hand side motors output should be throttle minus error times KP. And then right-hand side is just another direction. And then I'm just setting the motor output. And then these values will pass to the simulation. So let's run this. So I will make sure this simulation is connected. And then I will run Python VR halfdrone.py. Then that's my graph. Now I'll try to nudge this thing to CCW, and then it's oscillating forever back and forth, left and right. And that's because it's only a proportional controller. Now let's try to implement PD controller. Okay, I have added a term for KD, which is 0.1. And then I'm just literally subtracting this velocity because it's getting higher at the zero. So with the different direction, subtracting this. And what I mean by subtracting, because they are the same sign, right? If I look at theta dot here, there's a minus sign here. So inherently, this will make this entire term as an opposite sign compared to this part. So I am subtracting the higher velocity as it goes high, right? So let me try to run this. Do the same. And then that's my graph. If I try to nudge this, it will just balance as if it's nothing. So that's the PD controller. Now I have implemented a PID controller. And all I did is just adding this line, error integral. And then I have defined this function. What it does is literally accepting the current error. And then I'll just blindly add error to my self.error integral. And then this part is just all about thresholding this error between 100 and negative 100. Now down here, also I have added self.integrate error and then passing error. And then this function will eventually update this value self.error int. And then this ki is defined here. So I'm just literally adding integrated term with this ki constant. And then the rest of the code is the same. Let me try to run this. And then that's my PID controller. I'm going to add some right side motor, unbiased. And then this dip here is actually overshooting, and then it's just almost immediately converging into zero. If I try to nudge this, it's working. It balances as if it is nothing. So how cool is that? So that's the PID controller with this simulation. That's it for this video. And then next video, I'm going to do the exact same thing in Arduino with the actual device. Until then, adios. Thank you. If you found this content helpful, hit the like button. Your support means really a lot to me. Also, I plan to keep posting the video like this, so stay tuned by subscribing my channel. We'll all deserve to learn in the most simplest way. I'll see you in the next video.